Game of Thrones, the final season. We are going to review the whole season and the series finale. And be prepared, for the theme of this entire episode is, we got what we wanted.
But not how we wanted it.
Babe, Game of Thrones is on tonight. It's the series finale. Khaleesi is marrying Jack Sparrow. Oh God, that show has really gone off the rails.
Look, it makes sense if you've read the books.
Welcome to Durbania. I'm Durbin.
I'm Laura.
And this is our spoiler talk review for the final season of Game of Thrones and that letdown of a series finale.
Mostly, yes.
Oh my gosh. Now, I don't think Laura and I are going to hate on this, kind of like how the internet has absolutely hating on it, because the internet's kind of weird and there's petitions to rewrite the season and
which
redo it.
Stupid.
That is stupid. So we're not going to be like that. There's a lot of positives and we'll talk about some of those positives, but I feel like, as a whole, you and I are both like, this is not our favorite season.
I know. Well, I think part of it is they knew they had to wrap up this epic tale. Like, because we love seasons 1-7. And, like, how they're trying to tie in a lot of these loose ends. And it just, a lot of it up into this episode was very clean cut. Very easy. Very...
Yeah.
And I'm like, one of the things we said at the beginning, we were very let down by how things happen. Like, we got a lot of things we wanted. Like, we wanted Cersei to die.
Yeah, we got that, but that's...
But we wanted her to meet a horrible death like Joffrey.
Yeah, and her death was super quick and gone, and she was all like...
Eh. Yeah, and then Jaime Lannister being with her. Yeah, whatever. He loves his sister. But, I mean, the whole...
That was sad to me, though, that he went...
Oh, the booty call with Brienne Tarth and then left for that. I
yes.
just... I'm like... Come on. I'm like, I thought you were turning and becoming a new person. And obviously, he just went back to who he used to be because of Cersei.
Yeah.
And I just, a lot of those little disappointing things that occurred for me.
So I think, Laura, this is something you and I could agree is going to be both a positive and a negative. Mm-hmm. The entire episode where they battled the Night King and the White Walkers.
Like, yes.
I thought, aside from it being dark, but that didn't bother me so much that the episode was so dark.
Mm-hmm. We had to watch it in the dark.
I loved having an entire episode that was one humongous battle.
Yes.
And I thought that battle was great. I thought the score in that episode was fantastic. The action was fantastic. Everything about that episode I thought was pretty fantastic.
Yes. The problem, though, is it was too early.
That's it. See, we got what we wanted. We got a battle with the White Walkers, mm-hmm. and it was a massive, epic battle. And Arya killing the Night King?
I was okay with
that. That was amazing.
I'm good.
But the fact that it happened that early and they were built up as such a big threat and taken out that early, that was the part that was disappointing.
And the one thing I was kind of wondering was, so just for that whole Night King White Walker fight, Bran, when, you know, Theon Greyjoy and all his men are surrounding him and he just like... does his warg thing. I don't know how else to explain it. Where did he go? What was he watching everything?
I think he was crows flying around
So that's one of those things that I'm like, I wish they would have explained a little bit more about what he's going on. Because, I mean, at the end of this episode, he said, you know, how he found the dragon. I always get his name wrong. But he's like, oh, maybe I can help with that.
Yeah.
And I'm like, how? Can you become him? I'm like, because there was a moment there I thought he became him, but I don't think so.
Yeah, like the one moment in the final episode where the dragon burned the Iron Throne, it felt very specific, and that was fantastic.
Yes.
And I'm like, after a little bit, I was like, was that Bran? Did he take over the dragon's mind? But then
and
later
that's
on...
And why Jon's not dead?
Yeah. And then later on, I was like, no, that's not what happened at all. The dragon was mourning its mommy. But anyway, we'll get to that talk in just a little bit. But that, to me, was the pattern of the season. I kept getting things that were looked good mm-hmm. and good action, and then I was left disappointed.
Yeah.
Like, here's what I would have liked to have seen with the Night King. I would have liked that episode to be as epic as it was, but the Night King to continue moving south and bringing winter with him the more south he goes. So the survivors of Winterfell mm-hmm. try to cut him off and beat him. They all get down there. I would love to have seen Cersei become a zombie. I would have loved that.
But that could never have happened.
No,
but I agree. That would have been awesome.
No, it could never have happened. But this is just me kind of like going in my head, like, let the Night King be the final, final, final thing, because I feel like the huge buildup of the show isn't just who's going to take the throne. It was the White Walkers and the threat that they represented.
Mm-hmm.
And so the fact that their threat was neutralized that quick in this final season, the episode where they were neutralized, done well.
Well, and I think it's just we've had buildup for 7 years,
yeah.
and it went down to just one episode, one battle.
And they're gone.
I mean, I wish we would have seen them decimating some of these other cities.
Yes!
You know, and then leading up to this battle. So this way...
And then Arya still kills the Night King.
So much higher.
Yes!
But instead you hear, oh, they're at this place. We see nothing. Oh, they're at this place. We see nothing. The only time we saw some lead-up fights was in season 7. And that just, it wasn't enough.
Yeah, so I don't know. So that was one big disappointment for me. I think another thing that was kind of weird for me. So, we have Khaleesi, and what I liked at the end of season 7 was, I didn't know who was going to sit on the throne. When we got the reveal that Jon Snow was actually Targaryen, and he had the better claim to the throne, I thought that was a fantastic twist, because it's like, at that point, I love Khaleesi, mm-hmm. and I love Jon. And I would have
they can rule together, power couple.
Which would have been disgusting, but at the same time, cool. But the point of that is like, I would have been fine with them both ruling, I would have been fine with one or the other. But then it felt like they wanted to make things a little too convenient. And so you get to the episode where she turns mad and lays waste to innocent women and children.
Well, she turned mad before that, but that's when
everybody
saw that she turned mad.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. But you see what I mean? It's like, it just felt like a convenient writer's turn to kind of turn us against her mm-hmm. and then turn us towards Jon Snow so that they could pull one final rug out from under us.
Yes.
And I was just, there was something about her turn and her decimating that city that was very unsatisfactory to me.
Yeah, and we both kind of laughed because Simpsons predicted it.
Oh yeah, that was funny to find that on the internet.
Yes.
Yes, because I have not seen that episode of The Simpsons, but anyway.
Yes, but we just saw the meme. It made us laugh.
Yeah, it's just sad because I really liked Khaleesi. I did.
Yeah.
And I was...
Well, we were rooting for her. I mean, Daenerys is an awesome character.
Yes.
And so she gets to this point of being... I think it was too perfect.
Yeah,
And she didn't have any other powerful woman to go against her until she met Sansa. And when she realized with Sansa that the people didn't love her, and she realized the only way to get them to love him would be through fear. And so that started working in her mind, and nobody talked her out of it.
Well, she gave up on love and was at least going for fear.
Yeah, and she's like, well, so be it. I'll take down the queen.
So, and you know, we wanted Cersei taken down.
Yeah.
And we wanted Khaleesi the dragon and them to face Cersei.
Yes.
But having her escape and escape with Jaime and then have the castle kind of fall down on her with no final face-off between Khaleesi and Cersei.
Or even Arya.
And again, not like Cersei could wield a sword. We've never seen her be, like, you know, and actually fight her.
Yeah, but I would think she would have some basic combat skills.
Yeah, but at least to have them face each other one last time and have some epic, like, lines thrown at each other.
Where the dragon blew fire at her, even. Just looked at him, oh, peace out.
Yes! Like, I mean, that would have been, like, cooler than just...
And it was so close to happening!
Yes! Then Jaime kind of just going back to his sister. I mean, I know she was pregnant with his kid.
She says.
Yeah, could have been a lie. And we'll never hear the truth, but I do actually think she was pregnant.
But, so, one of the things that more disappointed me, which I've already kind of mentioned, was satisfying deaths. Mm-hmm. There was only one in this entire show to me, and it was Theon Greyjoy.
Oh my gosh! His redemption
He got redeemed.
Yes.
And he stood his ground, and he died at the Night King's hand, protecting Bran. And I'm like, that to me was a very fitting death. And I'm like, for him, because, I mean, he went from somebody who was annoying to somebody you liked, to somebody you absolutely hated, to somebody you pitied, to somebody you kind of were okay with, and then you didn't like, and then you loved him again. And I'm like, what a transformation of this character.
Like, of all the characters on the show, his character arc was the most fascinating from where he started to where he mm-hmm. ended. And so his death at the hands of the Night King, one of those things that was just so flippin' well done. Like, I loved his character arc, and the ending of his character was probably the best ending of all the characters.
I agree. And it's like, because that was, for me, I might be missing somebody, but to me, that was the only death that I was like, that was satisfying. He deserved... Yes. Nobody deserves to die, I guess, but that was a righteous death. And he proved himself and, you know, battle hymns will be sung about him, that kind of stuff, probably.
Yes.
Because if battle hymns are sung in movies like Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
And Lord of the Rings had a 30-minute ending and this one had an hour and a half ending. People complain about Lord of the Rings 30 minutes ending. Watch this.
Yeah, so actually that's a good segue into the series finale.
Yes.
Which to me, to describe the series finale, is to describe it as the end of Lord of the Rings after all the action was over and we spent all that time seeing where these characters ended, mm-hmm. and that just being this entire episode.
Yeah.
And I... So, okay,
oh, yeah,
so here's...
I thought they were going to go fight at Winterfell. I thought, an hour and a half. You can do so much in an hour
and a
half.
Yes, a final epic battle or something. You know, and all that time, like, turning her into the Mad Queen in this final season and turning us against her as the audience. And so, like, then what I wanted by the time we got... Before this final episode started, I wanted Jon Snow to turn against her and I wanted him to kill her. And I hated that I wanted that, but that's what I wanted. And I got what I wanted, not at all how I wanted it. Mm-hmm. It was such a letdown. I mean, okay. It was cool to see her dragon mourn over her.
Yeah.
That was epic.
It was the way he burnt down the Iron Throne.
That was epic.
Epic. And I wonder why he knew he needed to burn that, though. That's why I had for a few seconds, I thought, oh, that must be Bran.
Yeah. It's like the dragon realized everybody's fighting over that throne, and over that throne his mama was killed.
And that's why his mom is dead.
And so he burned it, and so nobody could sit on that throne that his mama was fighting for. So, I mean, it was poetic, and I really, really liked that. But like you said, here she stands in front of this whole army and gives this epic speech. The war is not over. From Winterfell to so-and-so, we are going to continue to conquer the world.
Yeah, basically she has to take over the whole world. And you know what's sad is for somebody like that, that's never going to be enough.
No, it's not. But
she's going to just always want more and more power. And once you have it all, where do you get more?
But it's the fact that she said Winterfell. And I was like, yes, we're going to have one more epic battle with mm-hmm. Winterfell. Like the free North fighting against Khaleesi. Like, I thought, yes, we're going to go to a final showdown. Jon is going to turn against her. And I love Jon's humility. Even when he's talking to Tyrion, when Tyrion was kidnapped, the way Jon is still like, no, she's my queen. And you can see that he's just fighting reasons to be loyal to her, but not finding those reasons because of her acts.
Yeah, but I don't think, even if Jon was offered to be king, he still wouldn't have taken it.
That's true.
Daenerys was still his queen.
Yes.
Like, you know, and him, he's the one who had to kill her.
I mean,
I couldn't have really seen Arya or Sansa mm-hmm. or anybody else doing it. I felt like it had to
be him. No, for the story and for the emotional impact, it needed to be him that got her. But I think I would have loved to have seen one last battle of Winterfell of the Starks versus Khaleesi. I think that would have been awesome.
But I think Jon knew if that were to happen,
His family would be decimated. Because, you know, like, her army's huge. So I guess there's no winning that battle,
and
so they
had
to take care of it. Yes.
Except for, one of the other things is I was wondering if Jon would be able to ride her dragon. But the dragon did let him through because...
Oh, yeah, when it was guarding the door and he went to hug her with the knife and take her out.
But
and it didn't kill her because it recognized the Targaryen blood, or kill him, because it didn't recognize the Targaryen blood in him even after he killed his mom.
Well, it might have been one of those things where, oh, my mom's dead. What's the point of this fight anymore?
And as much as there's no way Winterfell could have won another battle against them because her army was just huge and she's got a dragon, there was still something very anticlimactic about her death. I mean, the way the show turned us against her, it was something that I wanted, and I got what I wanted, but not at all the way I wanted it. Mm-hmm. And then the rest of this episode was just kind of boring.
Yeah, it jumped a couple weeks later.
I like Bran the Broken as king. Bran the Broken. Oh, hell.
All the lords and ladies deciding who's going to become the next king, and they pick Bran because, well, one, Bran can't have kids, so it won't be a generational kingship.
Where brothers are fighting for
the
throne.
Where they'll have to come and, you know, win the house loyalties to become the next king or queen of Westeros. And that I like. Samwell's probably my favorite character. No, Tormund's my favorite character.
Tormund is awesome.
But Samwell is like, we should, you know, let the people vote. I just started laughing. I'm like, there's no way they'd be able to figure that out in that time and age. And I'm like, but it gave me a good chuckle.
But, you know, the one thing I did like, I liked that Tyrion lived.
Yeah.
I liked that Bran the Broken appointed Tyrion to be his hand. And I liked it. I liked it when Grey Worm said, no, he deserves to die. He goes, oh, I'm giving him a fit punishment. He will be my hand and he will make right all of his wrongs for the rest of his life. I was like, oh, man.
And I was expecting a battle between, like, Grey Worm and Jon Snow, but instead you see Grey Worm taking off on the ships with his men. But the thing is, his queen's not there for him to fight for anymore. So it makes sense. He's just mad. And I just feel bad because he was so close to having, like the peace and joy that he wanted, and then his woman's head got taken off, and then his queen was killed.
Yeah.
And it just...
See, the thing is...
And then good for him.
The actual ending, I think, is fitting. I like Bran being a king. Yes, I like...
I like that too.
I'm okay with Sansa being queen of the North. I'm okay with Arya on the boat sailing to unexplored lands further west. And
it
I love
her.
That Jon going with Tormund into the wild.
Yes, and the question is... Does he step down from the Night's Watch and goes off with the wildlings?
I feel like that's what it indicated.
I feel like that's what it indicated, too. That because he doesn't want to be there, right? So he's just going to leave, and he's gone from that world.
And I don't think any of them care, but But the thing is, like, I thought the actual ending for the characters was like, oh, okay, that's fitting. Like, if they're all not going to die, and Tyrion being the Hand of the King and having a funny last line and stuff, like... And I love that Tyrion's alive. Like, that makes me so happy that he's alive.
He's one of my favorite characters.
So there's, like, there's things about it that I was like, cool, I can see that. But this whole last episode was just so boring.
Yeah.
It was just an extended ending of, like, Lord of the Rings. Like, well, the queen's dead, so let's just do a really long episode of...
I know, they could have, like...
Yeah.
...made her death more fitting. I mean, I have so many ideas of what could have happened. But it just, it doesn't matter because it didn't. This is what happened. The only thing that's disappointing for me is I because we both really like the first seven seasons, parts of this season as well, but I have no desire to go back and rewatch this show.
No.
At least not at this time. Maybe one day way down in the future.
Yeah.
But at this point, that's what's the bummer part about the season is I'm left a little bit disappointed. And,
it's over. And I know they're doing other spinoffs and prequel shows.
Really?
I don't care about them, actually. Like, it's like... I'm just kind of deflated right now. It's not like I hate this and we need to sign a petition and have them redo the final season. That's not
stupid.
Where I am at all. But where I'm at is just kind of deflated. There were elements I liked, elements that I was very disappointed in. And overall, with the final season and the ending of the Game of Thrones, I'm left...
Wanting.
Deflated.
Oh, deflated, wanting.
Yes. What is your final grade for the final season?
The show overall... I would probably give a solid B+.
That's a good grade for the whole show.
Because for everything.
Yes.
I don't want to rate the final season because it would have been an A if it was a good ending.
Yeah.
For the whole show. But it's probably, I would give it like a C, somewhere in the
C. I'm C- for the final season. I think my actual grade though, even more so than me giving it a letter grade, is deflated. Like, if I just tell you I am left deflated, I think you get it.
Yeah.
I am disappointed. I
but
didn't absolutely hate it.
The whole show overall.
Yeah, no, the whole show.
I give it a B+.
Yeah, I think I actually agree with that.
Yeah.
B+ for the whole
Would
show.
Would have been an A if the season rocked it, but that's okay. That's the way
that's life
goes.
There's a lot of disappointing final seasons.
I did enjoy my 8 seasons of watching.
Yes. Well, now that the show is over, what are you gonna watch? And what did you think of this final season of Game of Thrones? Let's talk about that in the comments. And while you're in the comments telling us what you thought of this season, what are some of the most satisfying series finales you have seen? For us,
Battlestar Galactica and Parks and Rec.
Like, those are some
those
of our favorites.
Like, those wrapped up so well. That's just well done.
So while you're down there, hitting that subscribe button, let us know what are some of the most satisfying series finales. So hit the subscribe button, hit the bell so you're notified for all of our new videos. I'm Durbin.
I'm Laura.
Thanks for checking out Durbania.